budget?
I think it looks like a very positive budget given the fact that we are coming out of a pandemic and the economy is hurting. So I think there is something for everyone. Maybe not all sectors which are hurting very badly. I didn't hear much on travel, didn't hear much on tourism, but there were certain definite positive announcements on the textile industry, which I represent for the group, so for the Aditya Birla group, so which seemed quite positive. Well, you know, there were two things which caught my ears and eyes in the speech. One was the announcement of the 7 mega integrated textile and apparel parks with fully loaded infrastructure. And these are supposed to be really mega parks spread over thousands of acres. And this is, as the announcement says, that these will come up in the next 3 years. So there is a phase plan. There have been many plans for integrated textile parks even in the past, but we have not been very successful in really launching them. But I understand that the ministry has had lot of study groups understanding how the Chinese textile parks function. Probably they've studied China and Vietnam, because there are some very good examples of very successful integrated textile parks in these countries. And hopefully they have a more cogent plan going forward, because it is very clear that the textile industry offers possibly the fastest and the best route for employment and large scale employment, which is the need of the hour, which was the need of the hour even pre-pandemic. And of course, post-pandemic, it becomes even greater need of the hour for India. And India is a very strong backbone of raw material support, capital goods industry for the textile industry. It's the largest cotton growing nation in the world. It has a sufficient supply of viscose fiber and polyester fiber, polyester filament. It is the largest producer of jute. So we have a lot of things going for us. It's got a good capacity for what we call the rayon, nylon, tire cord. So it's very well equipped in terms of raw material support, and also the fact that we have fairly competitive industry, both in terms of labor and power, makes India possibly the place to snatch or to grab an opportunity with some vacation by China on the textile and apparel front. So for a long time we've been thinking that the pandemic, which has had a fairly adverse impact in terms of imagery for China, could have been a good advantage for India to step in, but only time will tell whether we will actually seize this opportunity going forward, and these mega parks will actually deliver what they are meant to deliver. And the second thing which caught my ears was the announcement about source of origin in some of the issues of imports, particularly in the issue of free trade, which we have with our neighboring countries under various pacts that we have on SAARC and neighboring states. The country of origin issue has been a kind of loophole which has been exploited by some nations, particularly China, of exporting at very low prices to countries like Bangladesh, getting goods converted and pushing it into India as finished garments, free of duty. Therefore, not really having a level playing field for the Indian garment exporters, who are not able to access raw material at the same prices, making them therefore less competitive. So I really hope this is something the Ministry of Textile has been cognizant with for the last several years. And I think if they have actually found a solution to this problem, it would be of great benefit to the apparel industry in India for sure. So these are the two things that caught my that caught my attention. And of course, a very positive thing is the investment in infrastructure, which is very much required even at this stage in India, whether it's ports, whether it's roads, which will again go a long way in strengthening the capability of our country's exporters and manufacturers to really deliver value to consumers all over the world.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Shama.